The following editorial comment, praising the Regents and Commissioner Ambach, was broadcast several times by WPIX Channel 11 in New York City during late September and early October 1981.
The New York State Board of Regents has taken another significant step toward better education by approving a new plan which requires both public and private high schools to keep their dropout rates below 10%. Those schools which consistently fail to graduate at least 90% of their students would face the loss of their registration and the right to grant high school diplomas. What is behind the action is the generally accepted notion that some high schools might encourage their poorer students to drop out to ensure that the school's competency examination rate stays high. As you recall, one of the Regents' earlier actions was to require that at least 85% of a school's graduates pass the state's minimum competency exam. That, in turn, was intended to restore an academic standard for the high school diploma, which many believe has come to mean less and less through the years. As has been the case with many of the Regents' innovations, this latest rule has drawn fire from the teachers' union. Union representatives say that the dropout rate is affected by many factors and is not a reliable guide to the efficiency of the schools. They believe that it's unfair to blame the schools, that is to say the teachers, for things which are beyond their control. Finally, they warn that the Regents order will ultimately take money away from educational programs and direct it to plans to reduce the dropout rate. As we consider the matter, the management of WPIX would agree that many factors are involved in the dropout rate. Were that not so, the Regents standards would be much higher. But we find it hard to believe that anyone would disagree that good teaching is the key factor in getting a good education. Through the years, we've been greatly impressed by State Education Commissioner Gordon Ambach and the Board of Regents for systematically removing the excuses for poor education in New York. Through the thorough and methodical application of rules which establish accountability and professionalism in education, they are making a difference, and we think they deserve wide support for this latest action. What's your opinion? We'd like to know.